50 years ago, government introduced the National Chocolate Day celebrations. This coincided with 14th February, where we mark Valentine's Day. The initiative, we are told, is expected to boost domestic consumption of cocoa-based products as well as chocolate. It's also supposed to boost tourism. 15 years down the line, are we there yet? I don't know. Send us your views and comments on all our social media platforms, TV3 Ghana. I've been joined in studio by Dr. Edward Ampofo, who is the chief pharmacist with Cocoa Clinic at the Ghana Cocoa Board. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right. 15 years. Is there anything to celebrate?
Oh, certainly. Certainly. I mean, talking about cocoa and 14th of February. It's a yearly affair, and there's always a reason for you to celebrate cocoa on 14th of February every year.
Yeah, but let's look at the trend. 15 years.
Yes.
Are we increasing in sales? Do you think people are consuming Ghana-made chocolate?
Oh, yes. Because if you look at the demand generated around this time of the year, and every so often the producers or the processors try and increase the supply just to meet the demand based upon the previous experience, and every so often they still have grounds to still go and produce more to meet the demand. So I can say that looking at the demand and the trend, we up.
Do you agree that we are not marketing Ghana's cocoa well? Do you agree with concerns that we are not marketing Ghana's cocoa? Because if you look at, together with Cote d'Ivoire, we produce a larger chunk of, you know, cocoa worldwide. And if you look at other countries like Germany, Switzerland, France, etc., they are making more money than we are. Do you agree that we are not monetizing cocoa well in Ghana?
Well, what I would say is that we are working hard to actually promote the consumption of cocoa in Ghana, but there's still room for us to do more. That's what I can say.
No, so what are you doing currently?
Oh, currently, I mean, part of the things you are doing for the 14th of February, you know, it is all meant to increase the consumption of cocoa. What you didn't know about cocoa as a Ghanaian, being the country that produces the best quality cocoa on the international market, to the extent that your cocoa is still the gold reference, is a standard, is a yardstick by which other cocoa products from other countries.
Yeah, but I mean, that is clear. I mean, everybody knows that Ghana's cocoa is rich, and because you even find people say that, oh, this cocoa is made from Ghana.
Yes.
This chocolate is from Ghana. Yeah. But why are we not getting as much as we should from our cocoa and other cocoa-based products?
If you say as much as we could, you know, there are things, there are basically so many things you can use cocoa for, you know. Hitherto, people have known cocoa for only chocolate, and that's for pleasure. But even there with chocolate, there are varieties, you know, in terms of nutrition and even the health benefits. Then you have other products like the cosmetics and even the industries, you know, where cocoa can also be used, you know. So if you look at all and even what is happening now currently in terms of value addition, when we started this program, the amount of cocoa, you know, that actually was consumed here, you know, was less. But over the years, if you look at the number of processes who have sprung up, you know, as a result of this initiative, it just tells you, you know, that more has been done to increase the consumption of cocoa.
Well, what's the collaboration between the Ghana Cocoa Board and the Ghana Tourism Authority? Because if you look at one of the objectives for this National Chocolate Day celebration, we are saying that we want to promote domestic tourism using cocoa-based products and chocolate for that matter. What's the collaboration like?
Okay, I mean, the theme for this year's celebration is my chocolate experience, my holistic well-being. Tourism, I mean, you would realize even the interest generated by the year of return this year. And if you notice, I don't know whether you saw some of the clips where Ghana Tourism Authority were sharing or distributing cocoa products, chocolate and things, even at the arrival hall of Ghana. You know, it's
free.
It's all part of the effort being made to actually increase or promote the consumption of cocoa products in the country. So that when you come into the country, one of the first things you should see, I don't know whether you've been at the arrival hall of the airport, the new airport and all that, you will see cocoa products visibly, you know, there. You know, it is something that should hit you as soon as you get into the
country. But must it be free?
Well, that one was for a purpose, you know. people coming into the country in their droves for the year as part of the year of return, 40 years, you know, after the first slave landed on the Jamestown, in Jamestown in the USA, and they coming back now to come and mark the event with us. We thought that, well, it was in order to give it to them. It wasn't big. I mean, just pieces of chocolate given to them just to announce that what we are back into the country of
I will let us talk about our biggest challenge with regards promoting Ghana's cocoa and other cocoa-based products. But before then, you say your theme for this year is my chocolate experience, my holistic well-being. What does that even mean?
My chocolate experience, we you know, when we look at our hashtag and even the sites that we have asked people to go to, we want people to take pictures of themselves, you know, actually enjoying chocolate, the varieties of chocolate available, you know, and take pictures of themselves and place it on these websites. And we have a competition running, you know. After some time, we are going to look at the number of likes that you have generated with the kind of pictures or the kind of celebration, you know, that you have put on the website. And we are going to use that to award prizes to the winners, you know. And that's why we are chocolate experience, because we want people to know that chocolate can be consumed and used in several forms and in several ways, you know. And the holistic well-being, you know, hitherto people have only known chocolate to be something for pleasure, you know. So like Valentine is coming,
right,
you know, and so they will want to eat chocolate and all that. Yeah, the pleasure is fine. Yeah, chocolate is nice. I mean, I am yet to see a female or a lady who you will offer chocolate to and they will decline. I mean, it's fine. But we also want to tell people that chocolate itself is also good for nutrition. If you look at the cocoa and amount of things in there, it's also good for nutrition.
Right.
Some people are aware of that. The other aspect we people, many people may not be aware, is the health benefits, you know, where several health issues, high blood pressure, you know, high blood sugar, high cholesterol, you know, improving your cognitive and learning abilities, memory, you know, improving your iron content, you know, reducing your fatigue, you know, and improving your outlook and all that. These are all health benefits of the cocoa that many people may not be aware of.
Before we wrap up the conversation, what do you think is the biggest challenge for the Ghana Cocoa Board in promoting, you know, Ghana made chocolate?
Well, we want, I think that people sometimes think that what is produced outside, you know, sort of supersedes what is produced
perception
here. There's a perception what is produced here, but I can tell you that the chocolate produced here is far, far, far better than what you consume outside. Because there...
So we should look at branding, because perceptions are perceptions.
Let me just come in.
So does it have to do with an issue?
The presentation or what?
Yes, presentation.
So, I mean, when I was coming, I brought some of the products here, you know, but unfortunately, I wasn't allowed to display them. But if you see the products being presented now by local processes, as compared to what they had many years ago, you can see there's a big difference.
Improvement, okay.
Big improvement in the way cocoa products are presented now. In fact, they're of international standard and they are being demanded highly across the world.
So for you, you haven't told me what your challenge, the biggest challenge in promoting cocoa beans.
Well, the biggest challenge is getting people like Etonam to believe that we are made in Ghana. Made in Ghana.
I believe made in Ghana.
Chocolate, I mean, it can even be superior to what they are consuming, because the other ones are full of additives.
Right.
You know, what happens is that, let me tell you one secret.
Your point well made. We don't have enough time, would have just gone and on. So what Ghana Cocoa Board is telling you this year is that take a picture of yourself and join any made in Ghana cocoa or chocolate product at any tourism establishment. Share on Facebook, Instagram or Twitter with hashtag My Chocolate Experience 2020. Hashtag my chocolate, chocolate day 2020, hashtag eat Ghana. And you could, you know, win some prizes on 14th February at Alisa Hotel. I've been speaking with Dr. Edward Ampofo, who is a chief pharmacist with Cocoa Clinic. We've been speaking about preparations towards this year's National Chocolate Day celebration.